Welcome to Talking Fashion, the weekly broadcast featuring community leaders who know and understand the power of dressing for success. Join Robert Ford and friends as they build a legacy of productive men through character, leadership, and fashion. So are you ready to empower?
I can't hear you.
Ready to make a difference?
Come on, I can feel it.
Ready to change lives?
Can you feel it?
Join Robert Ford and friends. It's genuine, authentic, candid talk. Just keeping it real. Can you feel it? Welcome to Talking Fashion with your host, Robert Ford.
Hey guys, welcome to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. My, I have a dear good friend of mine on this show today. Man, wait till you guys meet this brother. Man, he lived in LA. I think he went to UCLA. Yeah, I think that's right. Now he's living in Flowood, Mississippi. He's one of the top lawyers. Loved the game of golf, loved Christ. This brother, I'm so honored to have him on my show. I'm so honored. I'm so honored, man. I love this brother, man. My friend, Mr. Attorney Willie Abston. Come on up, my friend. Come on up, man. My. Good to see you, baby. Good to see you, man. Hey, thank you for coming on the show. You know, we are going through a little bad weather right now, but that's what friends are for. We'll go through the storm for you. Oh! We'll go through the storm for you. And this brother, you are blessed. And you bless other people. Man, I want you to tell your story today, man. We want to help these young kids, man, in the inner city of Jackson and surrounding cities about your success being a top-notch lawyer. Education is big in your family. Your son, your daughter's doing well. Your wife, man, you're just awesome. So, guys, put your seatbelt on. Get ready to get blessed. I'm somehow blessed at the highest level with this man, Mr. Willie Abson. We'll be back shortly with Talking Fashion with my friend, Mr. Willie Abson. We'll be back shortly. You're the reason that I am like
this. Ain't a day gone by. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi partners with our communities to promote living healthy. With the compassion of the cross and the security of the shield, we're empowering you to take control of your personal wellness journey and to find the joy of being active at every age and helping you build proud, healthy communities with a heart of hospitality, because it's about you, your health, your life. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue.
Circuits deliver power by making connections. At Entergy, we believe that works for people, too. The next generation is our connection to the future. So every year, Entergy invests millions of dollars in education to teach skills for better jobs, to build a brighter path. To us, making connections means more than electricity. It means fulfilling promise. And together, we power life. Entergy.
Hey guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friend. My friend, my special guest, Mr. Willie Abson. Welcome to the stage, man.
Thank you.
Welcome to the show, baby. We at the big lead now, baby. We at the big lead, baby. You know about them LA Dodgers.
That's right.
Man, you know, I've been knowing you for a long time, Willie, man. You're an awesome person, man. Tell our audience a little bit about who you are and what are you doing.
Well, just to kind of give you a little background, mm-hmm. I'm actually born in Mississippi. I was born
right.
in Hattiesburg.
Yeah, yeah.
My family moved to Los Angeles, the Los Angeles area, when I was just a little small child. Mm-hmm. So I did all my school out there.
Okay.
Graduated from UCLA.
The Trojan.
No, Bruin.
The Bruin. Okay. Who's the Trojan?
That's USC.
USC. Okay. Don't slap me like that.
We don't talk about
that. Oh, Lord Jesus. Okay. We're going to pray over this right now. All right. Yeah, the Bruin. Okay.
That's right. We don't talk about them.
Okay.
So I'm a big Bruin fan. and of course, Dodger, Laker fan.
Yes, sir.
But then once I came down here and visited the Dome, I became a Saints fan and kind of left my Rams. But came back here to go to school, to go to law school.
And what school was that?
That was Mississippi College.
Yes, yes.
Went to Mississippi College School of Law. They took a chance on me, gave
Come on,
me a
brother.
Scholarship.
What did they say up there?
Can I keep it real?
Can you keep it real today? Coach, you know what? We got some young people, man, need to hear your testimony. Yeah. Come on, let's keep it real now.
Yeah. Didn't have any money to go to law school. And some great people at Mississippi College School of Law accepted me. And then not only accepted me, but gave me a scholarship because I told them I didn't have any money.
Come on, Willie. Come on.
And so.
Blessed. That's right. Son, you came in on, I'm blessed.
That's it.
Come on,
that's
Charlie it. Wilson, baby. That's I am blessed. It. You that's are it. Very blessed. Keep going. Keep
that's
going.
It. We need opportunities.
Because ooh, say it right there in that camera right there.
We need to have opportunities, and I was given one. And so I didn't let Mississippi College School of Law down. I made sure that the investment they made in me was a good one by making sure that, man, I just stayed in the law school library. I don't know what happened during the first couple years of law school because that's all I did was study because these people took a chance on me.
Took a chance on me.
And so I wanted to show them that when they did that, they took a great chance and gave me a great opportunity. So graduated from MC.
How was your experience at Mississippi College outside of law?
Well, law school was tough enough.
Right, ain't no doubt. You know, I was an architecture major in college, man. Let me get out of school real fast.
Law school was tough enough, but some great people here in the state of Mississippi. Mm-hmm. So not only did the school and the staff and faculty there take a chance on me, but then individuals in the community.
Right.
I mean, I have to, you know, give a shout out to Judge Denise Sweet Owens.
Yes,
she gave me my first job as a law clerk.
Yeah.
And
you know some people where I live at right now.
That's right.
Up in West Point.
That's right. And then my best friend, Orlando Richmond.
Yes, my man.
Pastor there, Northside Christian Center Church.
Yes.
But all these people combined to give me an opportunity. And so I didn't want to let them down. Mm-hmm. And so I did everything I could. Studied hard, worked hard, did all the things that mentors and others were showing me I needed to do to be successful.
So this biblical quote, it take a village to raise a family. Do you believe that?
That's
it took so many people to get involved in your life to go to law school.
That's what happened for me.
Talk to me, baby, come on.
There wasn't, as I've stated, there wasn't just one individual, but it's a group. And continues to be a group of people who give me opportunity. And today, my clients give me opportunity to show my skills, show what I've learned, and just be that person that I really believe that I could be. Mm-hmm. But of course, we got to have help. We got to have other people assisting and helping.
Exactly.
And so, and that's why I love what you do.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you.
Just your story, and especially right now during this storm, I remember back when Hurricane Katrina, all the people that you fed and all the people that you took care
2005,
of.
2005, wow.
I mean, we're about to probably see that again.
Yeah.
And that just brings back those things, and that's what we have to have. We've got to be able to assist and help and give other people opportunities.
Come on.
Because there are a lot of smart kids that never will get to go to law school.
Right.
Never
get
to become architects.
Right.
Never get to have their own show or do these things.
Come on, Willie.
Because
you're keeping it real right now, brother. Come on with it, big dog. Come on.
Because they don't have opportunity. But that's where you and I and other individuals who have gained some level of success and have some abilities to with resources to help make sure that they get to school and make sure they and even get a good meal, just things that just help you that we take for granted sometimes. And so I'm really excited about what you're doing and excited to be a part of things that are allowing others to be able to rise up and show the skill level that they could have if they're given, a good foundation.
Yes, and I want to touch on that. It's not about me.
No.
Okay? It's about who we bring on to share their story, to get a message
That's right.
out there to our young people. Because we all been through some things.
Man.
Have it been perfect for you?
No, and if you keeping it real, mm-hmm. if I can do it, anybody can do it.
Say it again.
If I can do it, anybody can do it. I don't have any greater skill level or mental abilities than anybody else. One thing that I did that I learned from my mm-hmm. father is I worked really hard.
Say it again.
I work real hard.
Say it one more time.
In fact, I outwork most people. Mm-hmm. What I found in the state of Mississippi was on Fridays.
Mm-hmm. I want you to hold that. Okay. I want you to hold that, okay? Because we got to go to commercial. Okay. You know, we got to pay for all this here and all these beautiful suits up here. But guys, thank you for tuning in. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friend. And my friend, Mr. Willie Abston. I hope I pronounced
that's
that right.
Right. That's
all right.
Right,
we'll be back shortly.
The greatest impact we can have on the future is teaching our children to live healthy at home, at play, and at school. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi partners with our schools to support them in being places where our children learn about healthy habits and where they are empowered to achieve full academic potential. With the compassion of the cross and the security of the shield, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi is building a healthy Mississippi.
Hey guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and my friend, Mr. Willie Abston. Hey, let's follow back up on, before we went to commercial, man, you were sharing some great things.
I was just trying to let you know that it's about working hard. Mm-hmm. Not all the times will you have the mental prowess and all right. of the skills and abilities. But if you work hard, people recognize that. Mm-hmm.
You know, I used to tell my son that on the golf course, my son Robert, you know, I used to tell him when I was at Castle Woods, you outwork everybody and watch what happened. You go outwork everybody.
That's fun.
Are you feeling me?
That's good.
Come on
that's
now.
That's good. What I found in the lawyering business mm-hmm. was most lawyers shut it down pretty early on Friday.
Right.
And
oh,
so
yes.
I trained myself to work all through Friday. In other words, I wouldn't leave the office until 7 or 8 o'clock on Friday.
Wow. That's why I couldn't get you on the golf course. I said, man, come on, Willie, let's go. I'm busy. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
But some of the cases that I received and some of the clients that I received, they would call on Friday. Mm-hmm. And so but they wouldn't call me first. They were calling other lawyers
people.
First,
and they couldn't
but they
get
weren't
them.
There, and so they would get me, and that's how I built up my clientele.
That's why you're a bad man. You're a bad man, boy. I tell you, boy, you got that thing right.
Sometimes you have to sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
So I couldn't play with you on Friday afternoon.
Okay.
But I played with you on Saturday.
Yeah, you played with me on Saturday. Yes, sir. Hey, let's get to this next question, man. Man, hard work, guys. Hard work. Young people, hard work. Tell them right there, Willie.
Hard work.
We're going to get you guys there. Let's talk about your family a little bit. I know your family very well, man. My family and your family close, and you know we went to church together. We've done a lot of things together,
yeah.
man. Let's talk about the family, man, your wife, your son, your daughter.
Well, first, my wife and I, my wife is Carmen Abston.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, Dr. Carmen Abston.
Yeah, PhD.
We just had our 30th anniversary.
Give me some.
We've been
Boom.
Married. We've been married for 30 years.
Amen. Congratulations.
She is the Writing Center Director over at Hines Community College.
Wow.
She is a PhD in English.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So,
I need to go to her. She got to help me out a little bit, man. But you know what? I'm going to keep it real. If I jack up something, I just jacked it up. So let's keep it going. I'm from Jackson, Mississippi. No, we got some smart people in Jackson,
Very
Mississippi.
Very smart people.
I don't want to get it twisted now. Go ahead.
So she's just, she's the glue for the four of us. Mm-hmm. We have a son, Niles. Niles is 26. Mm-hmm. He's in Los Angeles, California, right. Following after his dreams. He wants to get into the entertainment field. And
so really?
Yeah.
So in what area? Specialize in what?
He wants to write, and he is doing some comedy work.
Tell him to come on the show, baby. Come on, we'll fly him in. Oh, well, I don't know about flying him in,
well,
but
I can get him here.
Yeah, we want to, because, you know, I got a couple young brothers, man, that I talked to over in Alabama. You know, they starting a clothing company, and they reached out to me, and they coming on the show next month. So we want, this is what we want to do.
Want to make an opportunity?
Yeah, give them an opportunity.
That's right.
Like someone gave you. Someone gave me.
That's right.
Come on.
Develop those skills that they have. Mm-hmm. So Niles is 26. Mm-hmm. He's in Los Angeles following his dreams to write and be in the field entertainment there. Right. Our daughter, Neo, is 21. Mm-hmm. In fact, we'll be leaving next week to get her settled in for her senior year of college.
She's at
California School for the Arts. Because she's an artist.
Yes, she's an artist. I remember them days.
She's brilliant. Just amazed me with her creations and the things that she's done in that field.
So, now, what type of art is she abstract, or just?
Basically, she does a lot of, of course she does the painting,
yes.
But she also has a photo. She's got a wonderful set of camera skills that
really?
She uses to do some photo journalism.
Man, let's get
as well.
Your daughter and your son and your wife come talk, help me with my vocabulary.
Well, they're the creative ones. So,
yes.
But then there's got to be a worker bee.
Right.
So that's me. So
you the worker bee.
So I feel you on that one.
I feel you on that, big dog.
But they do things that I couldn't. I mean. I can barely draw stick men. So.
Right. And they can just take it to a whole different level.
They're amazing. The things that they do. And so trying to get them to go ahead and get involved in those things that they're passionate about.
Well, you know what though, Willie, you know, Mr. Abston, you know, with our kids going to the same high school, and you know, I know he went to a Christian academy.
Yeah.
Is that right?
They went to Hartfield.
Hartfield. You know, we gave our kids, you know, great opportunity.
Yeah.
To exceed or excel in life. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We gave them, we took self out. I'm gonna put it on my kid. I'm gonna give everything I'm working for towards my kids.
Yeah.
And that's powerful. You know, I can say that about my kids, you know, Robin.
Yeah.
Awesome kids. So.
In fact, I saw Robin in the LA airport.
Did you?
A couple years ago, yeah.
Okay.
But that point you just made, yeah, it was always our goal that our ceiling would be our children's floor. So in other words, where we were, that's where they would start. And so that's the goal.
Say that one more time for me. I want to make sure I get a good understanding of that analogy.
Yeah. So the goal is all of the successes and things that we've accomplished, Dr. Carmen and myself, our ceiling, where we are, would be where our children would start.
So they wouldn't have
to start where we do.
Hold up, Willie. Hold up, Mr. Abson. Say that in that camera to all the grown-ups out there who have kids.
Yeah.
Please say that again.
Yeah. We as parents, as mentors, that village that we talked about, our ceiling, where we are, the achievements we've made, have to be the floor for our children so they don't have to start where we did. And when we do that, they can just take off.
Boy, that's great. Hey, hold on. Put your seatbelt on. I'm going to put mine on in a minute. Hey, guys, stay tuned. Talking Fashion with Willie Abston. My friend, Talking Fashion, life skills. We'll see you when we get back.
It's a connection to the world. A great starting point leading up to your final destination. A place where you'll see familiar faces, artists traveling, leaping even to different places. Because there are flight connections, then there are human connections. Those you can't buy a ticket for. You just have to be present. No matter where you go, you have something, some memory, some experience to hold on to. And before you explore it, you can get one more dose of vitality, hospitality, and congeniality, all at the Jackson Medgar Wiley Evers International Airport. Your pit stop for pleasant encounters. Your connection to the world.
Hey guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. My friend, my dear friend, Mr. Willie Abston. Man, boy, where you been? Where you been, brother? We had to wait 8 months to get you on the show? But I'm so honored and so happy to have you on the show, man. You know, like I say, you're a dear friend of mine. Yeah. You have helped me in my downtime. And I'm not afraid to say that to anybody. When I was struggling and going through some things, you was there for me, man. And I want to say I love you for it.
Appreciate it. Love you, Bob.
Okay. So what we're going to talk about, you know, this show is about fashion.
Yeah.
You know, you're a lawyer. You're one of these high-class lawyer men here in Mississippi in the Jackson, Flowood, Brandon area. What do fashion mean to you as a lawyer?
Well, it means a lot, but what I want to make sure it never does is compromises my message.
Ooh.
In other words,
hold up. Say that again.
Well, it's you want to look good, mm-hmm. and you want to be stylish,
right?
But I don't want it ever to over compensate or wash out what I have to say, because that's the most important thing.
Yes.
But what it should do is it should complement it.
Okay.
In other words, if someone hears me and mm-hmm. sees me, mm-hmm. it should all come together.
Be right, like, right.
Okay, well, he sounded good, mm-hmm. and he looked good.
And he looked good.
Yeah.
Right.
So they should complement one another.
Right, right.
And so
they merging.
And so I don't have pink suits and...
you ain't coming on my show with no pink suits on. Pink! Who are you, Willie Abston? I know another Willie Abston. I don't know this with a pink suit
that's
on.
That's right.
I got a hot pink suit back there we use for my workshop, and we put kids in it.
That's right.
And the high school kids would go crazy when they come out with this pink and green suit on.
Yeah.
This is what not to wear to an interview. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
No, that's good. That's perfect. Mm-hmm. And because many times, the first time I'm seeing someone or meeting someone, mm-hmm. may be in the courtroom. And so I don't get to make that impression the next day.
Right.
I make it right then.
Right then and there.
So not only do I want them to hear a good message, mm-hmm. but then they should get the full compliment of me. So I should still be wearing a very nice suit,
mm-hmm.
you know, that fits well,
right, right.
and looks good and has the right color scheme. So that way they say, okay, well, yeah, this, he's mm-hmm. got this, he's got this. And in fact, everything is complimented.
Do that line up with your style of work or your type of work you do?
Yeah.
Dressing for success?
Yeah. And, you know, whether we're in depositions, mm-hmm. at the office, whether we're meeting clients for the first time, mm-hmm. whether we're in a courtroom, you know, having to do, you know, argument,
mm-hmm.
Whatever case it may, we should always look our best.
Now, let me say something, babe. I got my clubs over here. I know you come out to the golf course. You ain't coming out there with no basketball pants on.
That's right.
And on tennis shoes. You come out there looking right.
That's right.
Now, why is that?
And that, again, we want to make the message has to be complete.
Right.
And it has to complement every style.
Say it again. What?
It complements every style.
Wow.
So no matter what genre or whatever mm-hmm. area I'm in, whether I'm playing golf, if I'm just out hanging out with the guys,
mm-hmm.
or if I'm in the courtroom,
right.
I should still have
excellence. If you're on the basketball court, you got the Jordans on, you got the Jordan sweat, you got the, you're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
You're out at the
beach. It does something to you inside by being.
If you look good, you feel good.
You feel good. Well, you took the words right out of my mouth. Okay, let's get into this deep question I'm getting ready to ask you. And I want you to do what?
Keep it real.
What would you tell a young black African-American young man in the city of Jackson about dressing for success and how you carry yourself? And we need this. We need this so bad.
Yeah, we have to do a better job.
Say that. Who?
We. And I'm not talking about the kids.
No. Say it. Say it again.
We. You.
Grown
me,
up.
Grown-ups. Adults.
Yes.
We have to do a better job because, one, we have to display it. We have to show it. But then we also have to use our resources to assist.
Right.
I mean, we can't expect kids to buy a suit or to
where they gonna
purchase
get it from?
Slacks and those things, yeah.
What are they going to go snatch them by the purse or go
right.
break in the convenience store?
That's right.
We have to man up.
We can assist
and take
that.
The responsibility.
Yeah. And first thing, though, is they've got to see it.
Mm-hmm.
And when they see it, they'll want to emulate it.
Right.
And
right.
then now we have to see that they want that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have to be a part of that.
So what would you tell a young black kid?
I would tell, first of all, if that's something that you want, you want to dress well and dress better, first of all, do the best you can with what you have.
Ooh, but then so hold up. You hit a nerve. You hit a nerve. Do what?
Dress, I mean, with what you have, do well with it. Because there's some parents that's spending a lot of money on some of these kids.
Oh, yes. I remember your kids coming up.
We spend a lot of money, and you can still be clean, be neat, be polished.
We're not talking about a suit.
That's right.
You just take care of what you have.
That's right.
Boy, and that's
then,
great. Well, go ahead.
And then we can graduate to the next level and start talking about slacks and a jacket. And then, you know, button-down shirt and a tie and those things.
Just move level to level based on where you're at that present time.
You show excellence with what you have.
Say that again.
Show excellence with what you have. And do the best you can. And then you do it in every level, every area you're in.
Next question for you. Why come on my show?
You asked me.
Oh, no, you didn't, big dog.
I mean, you know, Bob, with the things that you've been doing in the city of Jackson for the last 20 plus years, man, I know we're friends because we have the love of golf, but we also love people. When you love people and I love people and we combine, we can start doing some great things for people. So other people need to hook up with you as well so we can start doing the things that make our city better. Because I love Jackson.
Yes, yes.
I mean, you know, I'm from California and I've seen some great things happen in cities out there. And then I've got friends in New York and Chicago and other places. But man, Jackson is just an untapped resource.
It's untapped. It's very untapped.
Wonderful people. We have smart people. We have a great college in Jackson State University. We have so much in resources and people, but we got to come together.
We got to do what?
We got to come together.
We got to come together. And by saying that, I want you to touch on COVID-19. Reach out to our surrounding city about getting this vaccination shot.
Yeah, I would just tell you.
Say it right there in the camera. Talk to our people.
Be careful with the information that you're receiving. As an attorney, I expect clients to listen to me about those things that I'm an expert in, just as I do with the scientists. I'm not getting my information from Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. I'm getting my information from the scientists who have spent their lives doing this. And so as a result of that, the information I've received, I thought it was best for me and my family to be vaccinated.
Yeah.
And then with the booster shot that'll come in the fall, it looks like that may be something that we also may need to get involved in. But for right now, if you're not getting vaccinated, you gotta wear a mask, you gotta social distance, and you gotta sanitize and keep your hands clean.
Yes. We appreciate you coming on the show, Mr. Willie Abston. Guys, we will be running his commercial, okay, his business on our show. Just the love for me and the love you have for me, we're going to do that for you.
Appreciate it.
Guys, thank you. Thank you for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friend. And you truly are my friend.
Thanks,
love
man.
You, bro.
Love you, bro.
Okay, God bless.
God bless you.